Respected Hazrat Mufti Sahab, we the musallis of other masajid, our imams and committee members, if they don't follow the Sharia, then how do we do our Eid and Ramadan?
This question that the musallis of the different masjids encounter difficulties and hardships with the trustees and the management of the masjids is not only in one or two areas, it is probably a common problem in many parts of UK. And it is precisely for that reason that this gathering has been called up to teach and to educate the people of the correct concept of the moon sighting. And the solution to that problem is that these kind of gatherings should be held in more and more places, and there should be a greater awareness and an educational campaign to teach and educate the people. The trustees of a masjid, they have an amanat in their hands. It's a trust. A trustee got a trust in his hand. It is amanat. It is a responsibility. He has to ensure that the running of the masjid, the management of the masjid, is conducted according to the Sharia. And for that, it is compulsory and farz upon the management and the trustees of every masjid to go and inquire from the ulama-i haqq what is the correct Shari'i perspective of the moon sighting and implement that in his masjid. He cannot just sit back, rely on information. He should go out and make his individual effort and inquire what is the right thing in Sharia. Implement that in a masjid, promote it in the musallis, and not confine it to there, but even go beyond that and ensure that what is the correct rule in Sharia, the principle in Sharia, he should promote that as far as possible to the best of his ability. If he is negligent in that, then he has failed in his responsibility as a trustee of the masjid.
JazakAllah. Respected Hazrat Mufti Sahab, one alim said that if we leave the following of the sighting of Saudi, then we will be disrespecting the honor and the sanctity of Baytullah and Makkatul Mukarramah.
It is unfortunate that I would disagree with that. For sure, the respect of the Haramain Sharifain is an integral part of our deen. How can a person be a Muslim, true Muslim, respectable Muslim, if he does not have the respect of Makkah Mukarramah in his heart? How can a person be a true and honorable Muslim if he does not have the respect of Madinah Munawwara in his heart? How a person can be a true and honorable Muslim if he does not have respect for the different places of the Haramain Sharifain? It is an integral part of our deen and our iman that we have utmost respect for the Haramain Sharifain and all those honorable and respected places that are in there. Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi, he commences his 30th juz of Bukhari Sharif explaining about the importance of and the respect of Makkah Mukarramah, Madinah Munawwara, the different places that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has went to, the different places that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has received wahi and revelation. Go and look at the different tarajims of Bukhari Sharif of the 30th juz. Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayhi have elaborately discussed that issue. So, respecting Haramain Sharifain and the different areas of the Haramain Sharifain is an important and an integral part of our deen and our iman. However, this does not mean that we should digress from the laws and the principles of the Sharia that are set down by none other than Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We would respect the Haramain Sharifain for the sake of Allah. We would respect the Haramain Sharifain for the respect of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It would be an embarrassment that on one side we claim that we have respect for the Haramain Sharifain, But when the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is in front of us, then we give such interpretation and have total disregard for the proper explanation and understanding of the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What type of respect is that? True respect would be when the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in front of us, we say, Amanna wa sallamna wa saddaqna. We obey, we believe. This is what our Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned, and we will go by what Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us to do.
This is the same question that is in Urdu. The similar question has been asked in English. Respected Hazrat Mufti Sahab, some people say that when we perform the Hajj, then we look at the sighting of the Saudis. So some ulama say that if the Saudi moon sighting is incorrect, then the Hajj is also incorrect and incomplete.
This question is based on the wrong premise. The criteria of Hajj being correct and incorrect is not altogether dependent on the sighting of the moon. There's a hadith that is mentioned in Tirmidhi in Kitab al-Hajj. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have mentioned, Al-Hajju ma yahujju al-Nas. Hajj is on that day when all the people perform the Hajj. So the criteria of determining Hajj, maybe the moon, may not be the moon, but the validity and the sihat of Hajj is not altogether dependent on the sighting of the moon. If all the people go and perform Hajj, and on that day when they're in the plains of Arafat, in the sight of Allah, according to the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam that I mentioned to you, the Hajj will be absolutely correct and valid.
Respected Hazrat Mufti Sahab, some Muslims who are bayat to some shuyukh or markaz or darulums or Islamic institutes, they say that these shuyukh have a lot of taqwa and are very pious, therefore they cannot be incorrect.
Unfortunately, I would disagree with that. And I would think that it would be biased and it would be prejudiced to think that some shuyukh, because they follow the Saudi sighting and they are people of taqwa, so we should follow them. Then aren't there other shuyukh on the other side that also have taqwa and also have piety? And they do not follow the Saudi sighting. The criteria of following is not the shuyukh. As far as the shuyukh are concerned, we would have the utmost respect for them. They are our guides when it comes to ruhaniyat, when it comes to spirituality, when it comes to seeking guidance in gaining the closeness and proximity to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Most certainly we would seek their guidance and we try to get closer to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. But however, if the shuyukh have to say one thing, and which is in complete contrast, different and in contradiction to what the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has to say to us, then we are bound as Muslims to disregard what our shuyukh say and go by what the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said. It would be completely unjust to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to disregard the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and follow what my shaykh have said. The shaykh is secondary, first is shariat and the hadith of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Respected Hazrat Mufti Sahab, is it okay for our ulamas to say that for the sake of unity we should follow the sighting of Saudi?
If people have to decide, everybody has to decide based on a wrong criteria, I can never see any way unity coming out with that. All the time, it is the way of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala that He has created ulama-i haq and honest, truthful people. And it is mentioned in the hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had mentioned that my entire ummah will never unite on wrong and evil. Which means that if anything is abundantly, clearly, blatantly wrong, then Islamic history has also shown that the entire ummah have never made ijma on something that was wrong. If one part of the ummah have done something wrong, there was always through Islamic history we understand that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala created a group of people that corrected the people that were wrong. So, the criteria of unity is not following something wrong. The criteria of unity is following that which is correct and right in terms and in principles of the Sharia.
MashaAllah, we thank Hazrat Mufti Sahab. Firstly, I would like to thank all the ulama for taking out their time and traveling far, far distances and coming here to enlighten us on this important issue. At the same time, I would thank Hazrat Mufti Sahab also for coming, accepting our invitation, coming all the way from South Africa and trying to solve the issues and the problems that we are facing here in our country. At the same time, respected friends, thank you people also for coming here. And we as attendees, we also have a responsibility, and our responsibility is that now when we go back from here, we try and make amal on the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the advices that were given by the respective ulama. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he accept this conference.
Yeah.